I'm Margaret Rubega. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Ecology and Evolutionary Biology at the University of Connecticut. I use the bird class activity in my ornithology lecture, and the class is fairly large for an ornithology class. It gets to upwards of 100 people at a time, and so you can imagine that as a course in which people typically think of as an active thing, you know, when there's no laboratory component, that's a big group of people to try and get to think about birds in an active sort of a way, as opposed to just passively sitting there and listening to me lecture. I walk into a population of people who, if they're fairly typical, have spent many hundreds of hours watching nature programs on TV, right? And of course, nowadays on YouTube, online, people have a lot of exposure to this sense of stories and information about birds being something, this really cool story about an exotic animal that's somewhere else. And taking nothing away from these nature shows, which have taught a lot of people to value the natural world in a way that they otherwise would not, they have unfortunately fostered this incorrect outlook, which is that the natural world, birds, mammals, you name it, is something exotic that happens somewhere else. So I'm really very focused in the class on trying to get students to appreciate that the amazing, incredible, illuminating things that we talk about in lecture, the way that biology plays out in birds, is something that they can literally walk out of the building and see happening on the sidewalk right on campus. It's not something happening somewhere else. And you can say that, but it's very difficult sometimes to get people to appreciate that. So it occurred to me that I might be able to use Twitter in a sense to use their electronics against them, to force them to use their electronics in a way that would make them look up from the electronics and see what kind of a world they're actually embedded in. They're supposed to, outside the classroom, post a tweet at least once a week that says where they are, what they're seeing in the birds around them, and somehow connect that to course content. And the tweets are not graded except to the extent that it's a 3-point assignment. Every time you post a tweet, it's 3 points. And you either achieve all three of those things, you tell me where you are, you notice something about the birds, and you connect it to course content. If you do all of those things, I give you all 3 points. And there's a cap on the total number of points. My goals really were to use the tweets as a way to make the students take the course content outside of the classroom and internalize it, to see that what was happening, what I was talking about in class, was actually happening in their world all the time. And initially, certainly, when I first started using the assignment, all I was really interested in was whether or not that was working. And I didn't think too hard about the social aspect of the thing. I was much more focused on this is a tool to make them put in a place where I can easily get at it, these observations that I want them to make. But as soon as we started using Twitter, I was posting to the bird class list in order to encourage them, to give them examples of the kinds of things I was sort of expecting them to post. And the interest on the part of the students in having something that you could consider a conversation with me became apparent very early. So when that started to really show, I got way more active about keeping track of their tweets in real time and trying to be responsive, trying to retweet their tweets so that a sort of a broader audience of people might see them. so that they could get feedback from people who were not just me. The social aspect of the thing has also created instructional value to this that I did not plan at all. So as an example of that, I think it might have been in the second year that I was using the bird class, the Twitter assignment, I went during spring break on a trip to Belize. And I hadn't talked to my students about this ahead of time, and just on a whim, because I had internet access, I posted a tweet that said, "Hey, bird class, guess where I am?" And I posted my bird list for the day, some of the birds I had seen. And immediately, even though it was spring break, students were not in class, they did not have to be watching our Twitter stream, three of them came back and started trying to figure out where I was. And in the course of a five-tweet exchange, with me giving them nothing except the names of birds, which they then went and looked at the distributions of to try and localize where I were geographically, they figured out where I was, which blew me away. I was so excited. And when I got back, I brought the student who got there first, you know, some stupid little souvenir as kind of a prize. And she took it from me and leaned in and looked me in the eye and said, "I learned more about geography in that tweet exchange than I did in all of high school." The students who it really works in every respect for, I think it works for because it's self-directed, because it's a real life thing, because it forces them to discover things about their own world that have been there all along. So that sense of discovery happens to them just when they're walking between classes. And having that tiny little sense of discovery be rewarded through however small a social interaction with me or with someone else in the class, having it be acknowledged as a credit-bearing part of the course, as something that I recognize, when you leave the classroom and it hits you that something you're seeing is what we're talking about, is what we're learning about, that's what I want from you. That's what I'm trying to accomplish, is not that you regurgitate back to me the stuff that I told you, but that you take what we're talking about and you use it to put your own world that you encounter every day in a new context, to see parts of it that you couldn't see before, because that really belongs to them then, right? It's not just me. It's not me telling them what they're supposed to see. It's what they actually see. But I have had experiences in which students who at the beginning of the course said very clearly they were taking the course just to fulfill an assignment. They didn't know anything about birds. They weren't necessarily especially interested in birds, that by the end of the semester were going online on Twitter correcting people who were mixing up swallows and swifts and being kind of, "Wow, I can't believe you would mix those things up." Using Twitter as a way to teach other people external to our community in the class things that they had already learned, taking that position as an expert.